Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield. Joining me now is Sarah McLachlan. And it's really a pleasure to have you back, Sarah.
Thank you. Nice to be back.
It's great to have you here. And, you know, the Lilith Fair was just so successful last year. It was amazing. And I think it raised about over $600,000 for charities in the different cities.
$700,000, actually.
Was it $700,000?
Yeah.
That's amazing. It's a great number.
Yeah, it was very, very good feeling.
You know, this year, I know you do a thing where pretty much in every city you take about a dollar from each ticket to donate to certain charities. Is that the way you're going to do it again this year?
Yeah, we do the same thing that way. And as well, we have national or corporate sponsors who are coming in and doing a lot of different things. Some are donating money to different charities of our mutual choices. Levi's is donating tons and tons of clothing to shelters. Yeah. Basically, every shelter in every city we give money to, they donate clothing to. So there's a lot of different ways we're going about it, just trying to diversify and, you know, get to a lot of different people. But it's a great feeling to be able to give something back. You know, I mean, we all have a responsibility to do what we can do, and I feel like this is an amazing platform to, you know, to get everybody motivated and into giving money and giving back to the community.
Yeah, it's amazing. I also love the idea of the Lilith Fair Acoustic Talent Search. That's great. I mean, the young musicians out there already kind of get a chance.
Well, that was one of the things we really wanted to try and focus on last year, and unfortunately it was sort of, went to the, started at the top of the list and ended up at the bottom and just sort of fell by the wayside. We sort of left it to promoters and it didn't really happen, and it was one of the main focuses of this summer, and it's great because we had way more prep time, and Levi's got involved with that. We did the talent search across America, and it's just, again, it's that thing of, I feel like I've got such an amazing platform, and I've been so lucky in my career. I've been given a lot of steps up, and it's great to be able to give other artists the same thing.
Yeah, I think it's beautiful. And we're going to check out your latest video right now, Sarah, from Surfacing. Let's check out Adia on 120 Minutes tonight. Hey, it's Matt Pinfield. I'm here still talking with Sarah McLachlan. And Sarah, it's an amazing lineup again this year on the Lilith Fair tour.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, everything from Erykah Badu to Liz Phair. How did you come about choosing the artist this time around?
The same thing as last year. We just wanted to get a lot of diverse musical people, different kinds of music. I mean, it's great because last year we had a real hard time getting some of the artists from different genres of music because some of them hadn't heard of me, and they certainly hadn't heard of Lilith Fair or any kind of track record. So now we've come back with the most successful tour of the summer and saying, do you want to be a part of this? So it's great. We have people calling us this year. I mean, we had the same desire last year to put on a great diverse music festival, and we got a lot of flack because, you know, it's like called sort of the white bread tour. But, you know, we're making the same effort. We just got, you know, it was amazing to get people like Michelle Indegriocello, you know, Lauryn Hill, Erykah Badu, Missy Elliott, all these great artists from different, you know, walks of music. And that's the whole thing, is to, you know, go stick your fingers in every different kind of music. And for me, it's great because I get to hear all this stuff and I get to, you know, take it in, whereas, you know, I don't necessarily have a chance to turn on the radio or hear it anywhere else. And I don't know, live music is by far the best way to see things.
Absolutely, and it's a way for people with all the different artists from different genres to really experience different things and let their tastes, you know,
absolutely wander. I mean, we did the gig in Miami last Christmas, and Missy Elliott came on that show, and she blew the roof off the place.
Yeah.
And I've never seen, you know, a rap artist live before, and it was amazing. I've never felt that energy at a live show in my life.
Yeah.
So it's very cool.
Yeah, people have a lot to look forward to this year. We'll be back with Sarah, and she'll be performing for us in a little while on the show. But until then, check out the top 10 singles around America in alternative music this week. Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield here with Sarah McLachlan. We were just speaking this before about the fact that what festivals should be. It's kind of like how they started with the Monterey Pop Festival years ago, with everything from Hendrix and The Who to Ravi Shankar and Mamas and the Papas. I mean, just all
the
over
the place.
The
best that was out there, yeah. From all over the place.
Really opening people's eyes and ears. You know, one of the other things that you've been involved with recently is a couple of soundtracks. Now, you brought Black back from Solace for the X-Files.
No? Yeah, well, I'm a big X-Files fan. And William Orbit did the remix, which is very, very cool. And he did a fantastic job. Blew my mind when I heard it. And it's great. It's really fun to to have your music interpreted by somebody else. I think it's really, you know, flattering and entertaining for me to hear what somebody else is going to do to it.
Yeah, well, Sweet Surrender also, Ronnie Size did a drum and bass remix of that.
Which is really cool, yeah. No, it's great fun.
Were you a fan of that? Is it interesting to hear that take on some of the songs?
Yeah, totally. I mean, and again, it's something that doesn't necessarily enter into my musical world, except my husband's really into all that music, which is great. So now I'm starting to hear it. I mean, my favorite album right now is Ray of Light.
Really,
which is, you know, it's sort of taking a lot of that world and bringing it somewhere back into the mainstream.
Right, with Madonna and William Orbit together.
Yeah, and it's I think it's a brilliant match, and it's a really beautiful record.
Yeah, it really is, without a question. Let's talk a bit about, like you said, Angel and City of Angels.
Mm. Well, that was just a case of, they had the film almost finished. I went to see it, and they said, well, we'd really love to put this song in the film.
Yeah.
And I bawled my eyes out. It was humiliating because it was one of those sound studios in LA, and you have to, you know, I had to leave afterwards in this big lineup for them waiting for the room to go see another film. I had to sort of file through all these people's songs. Excuse me, but it's really beautiful and melancholy, and the song seems like it was made for that scene.
Yeah,
it's really beautiful.
Yeah, it's excellent. We're going to see it performed in a little while. But first, we're going to have the latest from the Smashing Pumpkins. This is the first video after the new album, Adore. It's called Ave Adore. Here it is on 120 minutes, right? Hey, it's Matt Pinfield still here talking with Sarah McLachlan. Sarah, after the Lilith tour is over this time around, are you planning to go back in and record another studio album?
No, I'm going to take a break because I've been touring since last June when Lilith started last year. Yeah. So we did record pretty much every show of a live tour in the springtime, so I'm probably going to put out a live record.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
That'd be great. I mean, you've done like the Money P with the enhanced CD stuff, and you've had some tracks appear on singles, but this will be a good thing.
Yeah, and I'm looking forward to a little bit of a break, too, where I don't have to just, you know, finish touring and go right back into the studio and do another record. I just want to sort of let it evolve naturally. I mean, that's what I had to do last time, even though I was supposed to go right back in the studio because it was so far behind, but I think I'm just going to give myself that break and just take 6 months and float.
Yeah.
You know, I've wanted to do that for a long time.
Well, you deserve to get that opportunity to do that.
Yeah, and we want to have kids someday, too, so I'm thinking about that.
Definitely.
And, it's an incredibly luxurious position to have, to be in the place where I can say, I'm going to take a year off and just have a kid and do nothing but be a mom. And it's amazing. Not very many people get that opportunity, so.
Yeah. I think that'll be a beautiful thing for
you. Yeah.
That's great. And, you know, servicing is now double platinum and more. I mean, are you excited about the success?
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, I was shocked. It was a really hard record for me to make, and I was just so relieved and happy when I put it out there, and it was finished, and I was happy with it. Okay, it's done. And then I started Little Fair, and then, you know, halfway, a quarter way through the tour, the album came out and debuted at number 2 on Billboard. It's like, just, huh? Oh, yeah, the album's out. What is on number 2? It's a big shock, because I've never really been on the charts. It's always sort of been an underground cult following, so it was a big surprise to me. And, I mean, it really has been a whirlwind ever since when Little started, and just the you know, the record getting so huge, and it's wild. It's been an amazing ride, though. I love it. I mean, again, it's so amazing to do something that you actually love and adore and make a whole bunch of money doing it.
Yeah.
It's pretty wild.
It's interesting. It works out that way. Well, that's great. I'm really excited for you.
Thank you. We all are.
Thanks for coming. Anyway, don't miss Sarah on tour with the Lilith Fair this summer. And if you haven't already, be sure to pick up her latest album, Servicing, as well as all the early ones like Touch, Solace, and Fumbling Toward Ecstasy. Also, be sure to check out the City of Angels soundtrack, which has her song Angel on it. And when we return, Sarah will be doing a beautiful performance of that song for you. So don't move, all right? Thanks again, Sarah.
My pleasure.
Good to have you.